A big congratulations to Boots Ennis. Not only is he 33-0 with 30 knockouts, not only did he get the stoppage in the fifth round, the round before Crawford, because they both have the common opponent, but he did it in front of 14,900 people, the biggest crowd in Philly in about 50, 60, 70 years for a boxing event, which is tremendous. I'm always happy to see that in boxing. It's hard to sell in boxing these days. Gervonta Tank Davis, with 12 sellouts in a row, is probably the most popular fighter in the United States, maybe the most popular fighter worldwide. And Crawford in Omaha. If Crawford fights any fight in Omaha, I believe he sells out the biggest football stadium out there in Omaha. Other places, I don't know if that's the case. But in Omaha, he's the man. And if Boots can continue fighting in Philly and building his family, Philly is a city full of boxing history. You're talking about Joe Frazier. You're talking about the Executioners. Google that if you're not sure. If you never heard about the Executioners, this is before Bernard Hopkins. Obviously, Bernard Hopkins from there. And obviously, you have tremendous boxing talent coming out of the city of brotherly love. So it's great to have boxing over there in a high level. It's tremendous. So Boots gets the win over Avanesian. Turki El-Sheikh, the man behind Saudi Boxing, who's very generous with his money, who makes big fights happen, says, I reached out to boxer Jerron Ennis and Eddie Hearn to congratulate him on his win, and I'd love to see Ennis in a fight with Crawford at 154 soon. Now, in the past when this came up, Crawford shut it down and said he has nothing to gain, he's not that. Like, he totally criticized the idea. But Crawford is an ambassador for Turki. I don't think he's going to disrespect Turki, and I don't think he's going to turn it down if he gets an offer. Especially right now, he's going to fight August 3rd against 11-0 Israel Madrimov. And Madrimov is a very talented fighter, not the most known fighter. I mean, obviously, if you're a hardcore fan, you might know him. But if you're not a hardcore fan, you don't know him. But he does have a strap at 154, and that's, I guess, the allure of this fight for Crawford to get a title shot. It's a 50-50 fight. I'm familiar with both fighters very, very well. Now, Oscar De La Hoya, after Turki posted that he wants to make the fight, says, please, Crawford and Virgil Ortiz will destroy Boots. Haha. And Turki says, let's see. Now, speaking of Virgil, he just had his press conference out today. He just re-signed with Golden Boy, multiple-year deal. And Virgil will be fighting Manley Bay August 10th for the 160 interim WBC title against Sergey Bojcik, who's 25-1 with 24 knockouts. Virgil, 21-0 with 21 knockouts. That fight, there's no need for judges. That fight's not going the distance. Someone is going to sleep. They sparred between them 50 rounds, and that's going to be exciting. August 3rd in L.A., I think the fan favorite fight will probably be Ryu and Pitbull. They're both very, very popular. Andy Ruiz will be very, very popular. Crawford and Madrimov is a title fight, and there will be some interest in it, but I don't know how many fans in attendance in the arena will be coming out specifically for that fight. We'll see. Hopefully it does. Hopefully it sells out, and hopefully it does tremendously well. But in Los Angeles, Southern California, we're close to Mexico. We're 2 hours away. And Pitbull's very, very popular. Ryu's very popular, and so is Andy Ruiz. And that will be the draw for that fight. Now, Crawford, he complains about the double standard. Now, I'll put a disclaimer here. When Crawford fought Avanesian, I was part of the promotion. I helped do the matchmaking. I helped in a lot of different aspects with that promotion. It was a tremendously successful. Crawford made a lot of money to fight Avanesian. And it was a sellout, and the fans in Omaha loved it, and it was a sold-out event. I believe the fans in Omaha love Crawford. They're Crawford fans, not boxing fans, if that makes sense. Just like if Manny fought in the Philippines, he could sell out 120,000 stadium. Triple G never really fought in Kazakhstan in his prime, but if he did, I'm sure he could sell out any stadium. Sometimes you got to go to your fan base who love you and give back to them. Tank does a fight right now in Baltimore. That stadium where the Ravens play is sold out in 10 minutes. It would sell out in record speed. That's what fans do, and that's what they do. So in Omaha, they really didn't care about who Crawford's fighting. He could have fought me. He could have fought you. He could have fought anybody, and he would sell out. And that's a blessing. That's a beautiful thing. So right now, he's saying, why the double standard? Now Avanesian is a world-class fighter. Double standard is crazy. Eddie Hearn, you talk good. But regardless, you fight whoever's in front of you. And if that's the fight, you fight. Chavez Sr. was 89-0. He didn't fight 89 champions. Mayweather was 50-0. You don't fight 50 champions. Yes, from time to time, you can take fights to give back to your fans, to stay busy. You get voluntary defenses, boxing a business. You got to make as much money as you can in the sport. It's a short window to maximize it. And once you're done, you're done. So there's nothing wrong with not having to fight killers every fight. And boxing fans have unrealistic expectations. If you just want them to fight the major fights and they fight once a year or once in a year and a half, that's not good for the fighter. It's not good for the sport. Back in the day, fighters fought much more often. And actually, you take less damage when you fight more often, because if you're in camp months after months and it's tons of sparring, that's where a lot of the injuries happen. That's where you have the concussions and the cuts and, you know, the all kinds of cracked bones and hand injuries. But when you fight, a fight is what, 3 rounds, 6 rounds, 9 rounds? Back then it was up to 15. Less punishment on the body. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. But let me know from you guys. Crawford and Boots Ennis. If Turkey's involved, I believe it would happen. I don't see Crawford as the ambassador for Riyadh season turning down a fight that is offered by Turkey. But first, Crawford has to take care of business on August 3rd. And like I said, that's a 50-50 fight. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. For EsNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback. Ellie Secback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.